Hello guys and welcome to Survival Russia again. So, mosquitoes have decided to come out, but not in full force yet. But today we're gonna take a look at a fire, experimental fire I came up with while laying in the bed, thinking at night, tra-la-la-la-la. I think and I hope it's gonna bring new levels of awesomeness to my camp cooking. So, collected some materials here. Birch bark, spruce twigs. Preferred fuel of the boreal forest. So the general plan is to stuff the spaces here with spruce twigs and with birch bark. And hopefully we can get all this to light up. And as you can see, this is of course a little bit different than a Swedish fire, but the principle is still the same. Not be too bad to get a fire going. Get this amount of mosquitoes reduced. Mosquitoes here, they don't care too much about fire and so on. Somebody have to forgotten to tell them that mosquitoes don't like fire. So I think you get the general idea. Quite a good amount of mosquitoes. Stuffing this here with spruce twigs and birch bark. Let's see if we can get it to light up as I planned to. Today's fire, sponsored by Cricket Lighters. Not really, I paid for it. But yeah, mosquitoes have come out. These two logs here seem to be a little close to the center log. So I'll just move them out a little bit, get like an equal space all around it. So far it's looking good. No more fuel down there. Fire's burning by itself. But you also must say there's like 20 minutes now. So why make this type of fire? First of all, I like fires who look after themselves, as you might have noticed. And this type of fire will surely look after itself as well. Good thing is, I'll be able to cook a lot of things on it. So have my Swedish kit there. Could have a skillet here. Stainless steel bottle and so on. Or I could have all the containers I have. If I was in a situation where I need to boil a lot of water, for example. And I could just stack them up here, boom, boom, boom. And they will look after themselves pretty well. I don't need to feed this fire anything for now. I use this silky katana boy to cut the log. Smaller saw can also be used. An axe can be used. Could have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe even 6 containers at the same time without any pot holders or anything like that. So it should also be relatively safe. Because as I say, it sort of like contains itself. Not a big, huge bonfire or anything. To make the whole concept here more stable, we could of course make them a little longer, the logs here, and dug them down. So they will have no way of tipping over, but they're straight cut, so they're standing pretty well. I'll not expect them to fall anytime soon. And though this is not a camping trip or anything like this, this is just training. And training is over. Got a cool result. That's what I say. Just get out and train. Get out of the comfort zone. This is comfortable here. No, it's not at all. And yeah, so check the links. And if you want to know what's going on outside the YouTube channel, check me out on Facebook on Survival Russia.